This episode of McCall's Quilting Quilt Along is brought to you by Moda, producer of quilting fabric and home of the fabric pre-cuts.
Hi there, and welcome back to the McCall's Quilting Peace Cottage Quilt Along. I'm Laura Roberts. I'm your teacher and your travel guide as we go through making this quilt. And we're going to start today with the Rising Star block. And you'll see that you have cutting in your pattern that's just for the Rising Star block. So you'll go ahead and cut those pieces out. And they're just rectangles and squares and some big squares. And I'll tell you how to handle those in a minute. But first, I'm going to get you started on making the little flying geese. So this is the block itself. And these are the pieces that are going to go into it. So here's the block we're going to make. And here are the pieces. All right. So the first thing you need to do is draw a line, a diagonal line, on the back of your little yellow squares. And it's just that simple. You know, you take your ruler and you just go down with a pencil. It's really easy, okay? And here is one that I've already sewn onto the navy rectangle. Now, this was one of the best tricks I ever learned, and I want to share it with you. Okay, usually you would cut your quarter inch seam allowance and then press this piece open, right? Well, instead of doing that, we're going to press it open first to make sure that it matches the blue underneath so that we know that we're getting the right size of rectangle once it's pieced. I'm just going to press it now. You don't have to, you know, pressing is not the same as ironing. Ironing, you're moving a lot, like pressing is pretty much, it's kind of gentler. All right, so here it is, pressed. You see that, how that's pressed over? And I'm just going to look at the back and make sure that my corner matches up. Now, there's a teeny weeny bit sticking out. So I'm just going to trim that right off while it's still on the navy. There, just trim that off like that. And then I'm going to come back to the front, put that guy back out of the way, and I'm going to cut the seam allowance off as you normally would. Just trim that away. Okay, so now I know that that's exactly what it should be, exactly like the rectangle underneath. Okay, so now I'm going to sew the second one. And I'm just going to align that like that, making sure that my line goes that direction and my corners, everything aligned. And I'm going to just take this over to the machine and show you how to sew it on. I'll put my glasses on so I can see. Okay. I'm going to use a little thread catcher first because I don't want to get, you know how sometimes you can get those, like a mess on the bottom of the piece that you're sewing and it just makes you sad, a little tangle of thread. Well, this is how you can avoid it. These are just scraps and I just sew right over them. And now here's my piece aligned just the way I want. Now I wanted to show you something. You don't want to start at the corner. Because if you start sewing from the corner can just go right down into the machine. You know how that happens, it just kind of swallows it. So start over here, but make sure that you've got it nice and flat, okay? So I'm gonna make sure I've got everything the way it's supposed to be, and I'm just gonna kind of keep that flat as it starts on the machine so it doesn't move that top square and get things out of kilter. Okay, there we go. Ah, come on, baby. There we go. You'll see I'm using purple thread. And you might wonder why in the world am I using purple thread? Well, I'm using purple thread so you can see what I'm doing. But it sure doesn't go with a quilt, does it? All right. Press the little button. This is the coolest thing. I love this little button. Okay, and what it does is it cuts off that thread. Okay, cut away my tail. And we'll go over here. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing I did before. I'm going to press that over to make sure that it lines up with the blue underneath. Okay, I've got that pressed down and I'm gonna turn it over. Is there anything sticking out? Well, there's some threads I can trim, but other than that, I think it looks pretty good. See that? Maybe that teeny weeny bit on the corner. There we go. Okay, so now I'm just gonna fold that back like I did before. Zip. And cut that away. So this trick works anytime you're doing a flying goose or flying geese. I'm going to trim that little bit off, and there we go. all set and ready to go. One happy little flying goose. Okay, so when you come over to assembling this little block, get these guys out of the way. When you're assembling the block, you're going to have four little flying geese. You're going to have an orange center, and you're going to have four navy squares that match the navy in the block, just like that. Okay? So it's helpful to lay the block out before you sew it together to make sure that you have everything the way it should be. And also, every block uses only one navy and only one yellow because you have an assortment. So you want to make sure that all those blues are the same. So now I'm going to sew that first row. Okay, whoops. I've got a rolling chair. All right, so making sure that the orientation stays the same, I'm just going to bring this over to the machine. Okay. And if you have a quarter inch foot, this is, you know, your quarter inch seam allowance is really super important. So if you aren't able to get a quarter inch foot, to get a quarter inch seam allowance without a quarter inch foot, go pick up a quarter inch foot. Okay, and away we go. Now, I didn't put this in, my little thread thingy. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna bring that presser foot back up. I sure don't wanna have to undo one of those big tangles. There we go. Okay, and I'll just sew that through there. And this is one of those times when if you want to chain piece, you can. So rather than taking that out now, I have this one all set to sew. I'm just gonna go ahead and sew this one too. There we go. Just align those edges and away we go. Okay, now your quarter inch seam allowance, you want it to come through there. This is the point right there of your navy. I'm just gonna come a little tiny bit outside it so I don't cut off that point, making sure these guys are lined, which they are. Okay, and if my quarter inch seam allowance is right, it should just do that on its own. Right on through like that. Okay. All right, let's cut these guys apart. And I'm gonna take them over here. And I'm gonna do some pressing. Now, you don't actually have to press this one open before you add that one. You could go ahead and add that one before you press. But we're gonna press it anyway and get rid of our threads. Okay, let's do that. Now this is called setting the seam. When you just press down before you flip it open, that's called setting the seam. And I never knew what that was for, and I wasn't really good about doing it until I found out that what that does is it integrates the sewing thread down into the fabric. So it's actually worth doing. It makes a difference. It'll make your pieces will come out more the way you want them to. Okay, we'll just press this. Now, I want to show you something. If I press this direction like that, I'm going to have a thick seam allowance. Do you see that? Because I'm going to be on top of it. So instead, I'm going to turn it over, and I'm just going to press that way so the extra bulk from the point goes underneath the orange square because it doesn't have anything else there, and it'll be a little light, nice and flat. So once I do that, I'm just going to do it from the front. Okay, and there you go. All done. And then what I would do, of course, is I would add the next square over here and then sew these together. So I'm just going to show you how to sew this to this so you can see how you can get things to match up. Oops. And what I want to show you is this has been pressed over to that underneath that little navy square, and that way you don't have the bulky seam on top of each other. And this one was also pressed toward the orange, and what that means is that your seam allowances are going opposite directions, so they're going to butt up against each other and just kind of nest just together like that. You can feel it. Oops, come on baby, there we go, just like that. See what I mean? Okay, and I've got those lined up the way I want. And make sure that my corners are aligned. You can pin here. I'm not much of a pin user because I'm really bad about sewing over them. But we can throw a pin in if you want. Show you what that looks like. Pin right there. Okay. And then you're going to do the same thing here. You're going to feel that. And just make sure those are butted up against each other. And you can throw in another pin. Okay. Now I'm going to just take it over here and sew it on in. Okay. put your foot pedal where it won't go down, and then all of a sudden it does, and it's like, woohoo! All right, so I'm just gonna put that right under on that quarter inch seam allowance, take my pin out. Okay, still feeling that. I can feel that right there. Making sure that those are nested. Okay, and when I get in here, I'm gonna do the same thing I did before. I want to just sew really close to that point, but just a little outside of it so that the point doesn't get caught down in the seam allowance. All right, just gonna sew right along. Like that, get that pin out of there. Okay, and I'm just holding the corner. Sometimes as you approach, this can skew and get, you know, you get too small of a seam allowance right there. So make sure when it goes through the machine that you've kept that quarter inch line right along the edge of your fabric. Alrighty. Just gonna cut the tail thingy off and then come back over here. And I'm gonna press this open. And you can press this way or this way. It doesn't really matter. You can also press the seam open, and that's what I'm going to do because that way the bulk is split. Since you have things that are going to double up on both sides, you're better off, I think, pressing this open. It used to be that you never pressed anything open because battings were not bonded and they were, you know, pretty loosey-goosey, and so you would have batting coming up through the seams. And that's why it was pressed to one side to keep that from happening. But we don't really need to worry about that now. Okay, and there you go. That one's all sewn together. And do you see how nicely those seams come together and our points are showing? And so what I'm gonna do, if I put this guy on like that and the other little square, I would have this center piece. You know the center there? Okay, and then once you have that little star, you're gonna do the same thing. Only the little star is now taking the place of the orange square in this one. So here are my bigger flying geese. You make them the same way you made the little guys, and you can just put them out around your little star, making sure they're oriented properly. I sewed one star like this and went, oops, and had to take it out. So try and get those points the right direction. And then my little dots, I love that. Isn't that cute? I love these fabrics. You know, who doesn't love Moda, right? But they're just so much fun to play with. And you're just gonna do the same thing. You're gonna sew one row, middle row, bottom row, you sew them together, and you end up with this beautiful little block, this rising star block. It's like having a little sunshine, you know, rising in the middle of your block. Okay, so once you have your blocks made, you're gonna wanna put them together. And the way you do that, you're gonna start by cutting really big squares of fabric. You're gonna cut 18-inch squares, 17-inch squares, and 14-inch squares. And I'm gonna show you what this looks like. Okay, the 18-inch square and the 14-inch square, you're gonna cut in half diagonally. And as I've already done here, but the best way to do that, if you're having a hard time, because you want it to go from point to point, if you don't have a ruler long enough, and very few of us do, what you're gonna wanna do is you butt them up against each other, like this. So you would get that right like that. Let's move this guy, because it's kind of bumpy, and I think I wanna show this to you really flat, and we'll bring it back in a second. Okay, there we go, that's better. Okay, so to cut something that big in half, pretend I didn't cut it, you're going to lay the ruler so that it's right on the point at okay, right on this point, going right over the corner. And you want it to go right over that corner too, but golly gee, it's not long enough. That's when you get another ruler and you butt it up against that first one. It goes right through that point. You hold them together and you cut very carefully and you'll have it cut in half. And the reason you cut them in half is because you want to get the straight of the grain on the outside of the assembled unit. So this is gonna be a big corner triangle, all right? That's the 18-inch one. You also have a 17-inch square, and this triangle is smaller than the 14-inch one. Why is that? Well, it's because this you're gonna cut in half diagonally twice. okay? This is called a quarter square triangle. This has the straight of the grain on the big long side, the hypotenuse, I think that's what it's called. Whereas this one, the corner triangles, that's bias. See how it stretches? And on this one, it's not. And that's because this one goes along the edges of the unit, and you want that straight of grain all around the outside. So this one you're going to cut in half diagonally twice, and the 14-inch one just gets cut in half diagonally once. When you're sewing your blocks together, it's really important that you not pick up the wrong triangle. If you're thinking to yourself, as you're sewing it together, oh, I need the 17-inch triangle now, it is so easy to pick up the wrong one. Make sure you remember that the 17-inch triangle is a quarter square triangle, okay? So, once you have that done, and another little tip I'll give you, when you're having to cut triangles and you're gonna have a huge bias edge like that, what I do is I press the square before I cut it diagonally, and I press it, I use, this is Best Press, it's a starch alternative, which I like it a lot because starch is a wonderful thing, but starch is just like the starch you're gonna find in a Cheerio. And when you use real starch, or the starch we all grew up with, what happens is that it can attract bugs because it's their food. And so there's nothing wrong with starch, but if you're going to use it, after you're finished with your quilt and you've got your leftovers, your scraps, whatever, wash them before you put them away. Because if you put them away with starch in them, you're just, you know, calling, here, here, come on, little beetles and moths and things. If you're using the starch alternative, you don't have to do that. So anyway, this is Best Press, and it comes in all these different fragrances and things. And that's what I used when I pressed my squares before I cut them. I did that because I don't want that bias wiggling too much. Okay, so obviously I can't fit the whole unit here. So I'm just gonna show you part of it and show you how you're putting it together. Okay, take a look at how these triangles are laid out. This aligns with the block edge, and down here, this aligns with the block edge. So you're sticking out like that. That's how it's supposed to be. These triangles are cut really large because you're going to trim this whole unit later. And that's why they're sticking out, and that's how you want it to be. I know it looks kind of weird, but it's fine. So this is one of those middle strips. If you look at your pattern, you'll see it. This is one that's going to end up in a corner. So it's going to end up with a 14-inch triangle on the corner. So I'm going to grab some triangles, and we'll figure out who's who. Okay, I know I need the straight of grain on the outside. Now look at this one. Oops, it's stretchy. No, that's not what I want. Ah, here we go. Look at that. Straight of grain, so I know this is a corner. Now, when you're looking at a crosswise grain, it's stretchier than the lengthwise grain, but it's nothing like the bias. Okay, so I'm gonna end up putting this guy down here, okay? Before I do that, I need to sew this to this. And just to get ready, I'm gonna lay out the big guy up there. Okay, when you're sewing these together, one of the key things is getting your alignment right. Now, the stars go into rows. If I sewed it together like that, that would not work out. That wouldn't be right. I need to make sure that I'm doing that, that my stars are going ding, 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 and that these bottom stars are point to point like that. And once I have this guy sewn on and these two, then I can sew them together. That comes on later. So I'm just gonna flip them like that and get my pins. I do sew with pins on these long guys. And what I'm gonna start by doing is by just aligning those seams. Just get those right there. Again, I can feel them. And like that, oops, there we go. And I'm going to make sure I want my points to match, to point to point. So the way to do that is you're gonna put a pin down from the top, right where that point is. Let's see how close I got. Oh, pretty close. not as close as I want to be. I want to be right in the corner. Okay, right there. There we go. There, okay. And I'm going to put it right through that point, like that. Okay, now what I want you to do when you get to this part, you keep that pin in here vertically, like that. I'm going to pin to either side. So this pin is still just straight on through. Make sure I've got that where I want it. Align the edges and pin to either side, like that. And then you can take that pin out, all right? And you would do the same thing here and here and here. Just do that all the way along. And I'm just gonna wing it because otherwise we'd be here for days, which actually would be kind of fun. Wouldn't that be great? Oh gosh, wouldn't it be fun if we were all together in one room, everybody making the quilt? Okay, here I'm gonna make sure that those align. And this technique where I'm showing you how to align the points is the same one I used when I sewed the blocks together. But one thing I did that was kind of different, and you'll see, I pressed this seam allowance open for the same reason. You've got all these layers of fabric here. If you press it to the side, you're gonna have a bump. You know when you iron over that bump and sometimes you get shiny fabric? Well, that's how I avoid it. Okay, so let's just go right here through the point. Now there's no point here, so don't need to do it. All right, just gonna lay that along here. There we go. I don't need to pin the whole thing, I'm just gonna pin there. And on the other direction, same thing. I don't have to pin any more seams together. I just need to pin this, aligning these guys. Now this is a bias edge. Oh, I'm gonna be kind of careful. You don't wanna stretch that because it will bounce back when you don't want it to. You don't wanna stretch that out now. Okay, there we go. And making sure that this lines up, that I have that going straight out from there, not like this. You don't wanna do that, you don't wanna do that. You want it coming straight out, just nice and flat, like that. Okay, now I'll take it over to the machine. I love my rolling chair. Okay, glasses on. Alrighty, I'll just get this guy down. Okay, and I'm gonna start down here, and you can see I'm gonna actually lift that presser foot up and get that under, that end, that triangle that's not being sewn to anybody, and then I'll put it down, making sure it's aligned, and get that pin out of there. Okay, we're just gonna sew right along here. Again, you're not gonna be using purple thread. When I actually made the quilt, I used white thread, because you've got navy blue and orange and all kinds of colors in here, and the white just seemed to work fine. You know, some people prefer to piece with gray, and that's fine too. And I'm holding that seam allowance down because I don't want it to get up. This is a time when I also use, this is an awl, and I use that, making sure not to get that under the needle, because that would be bad. That would break the needle, and just like a pin would. And just so you know, you break a needle, you know what happens? It goes flying sometimes, and your face is right there. So you really don't want to sew over a pin. Okay. And you really don't want to sew over your finger. I actually sewed over my finger last week. I think if you quilt long enough, you're going to end up doing that. Okay, so what I'm doing now is making sure those edges are aligned. Keep on going. And feel that. I can feel that those are butted up against each other with my finger. I can just feel that. All right, up and over. Okay, get that pin out. Okay, now I can feel this. And it feels like it's not quite aligned. So this is the advantage. You can really tell. There we go. And I can feel. Isn't that cool? I love quilting. And you can see that the bias here is really cooperating. It's behaving really well. And that's because of the best press. Grab yourself some. At home, it comes in this huge big jug. I don't know what it actually is. I don't know if it's a gallon or 2 gallons or what, but I buy the big one and just refill my little guy. Okay, and I'm just gonna keep sewing all the way across my little triangle edge like this. I almost did it, huh? I almost sewed over a pin again. And just keep that there and sew right on over. Okay. And we're set. Get my glasses off. And I'll just come over here. Cut off, oops, magnetic scissors. Cool. Just gonna cut my little tail piece off. Okay, there we go. So now, see, doesn't that look like it's supposed to look? Yay, those guys match up. Look at the points, they're just right. See that, the seams are just right. It's not hard at all. So, you would press this nice and flat, and you're now gonna sew on that 14-inch triangle. How do you do that? Look at that, that is so weird. Okay, well, I'm gonna show you how to do that. I'm just gonna grab this real quick. Okay, I want that to lay flat. And just, you know, just gonna give it a little squirt. Okay. Of course, if you're doing this at home, for real, you would press the whole thing now. And again, I would press this seam open. Otherwise, you're gonna have a big lump. Okay, but just to show you how you're gonna sew that corner on. Okay, there we go. And here's my 14-inch. Where is it? I better look. Oops, that looks more like a 14-inch. And, yep, straight to green. Okay, so this looks really strange, and I know it looks really strange, but all you're gonna do, you just lay that over, and you're gonna want to center it onto this piece. The easiest way to do that is to fold it in half, and you just finger press it, just to get a little line. And when you look at your block, of course, that's your center. And I told you these were cut over size, so you have a little wiggle room. You don't have to panic about not being exactly right. But there's my crease. Yep, that looks fine. Okay. And I'm just gonna pin this guy in place. Don't have any seams to match, so that makes life easy. There we go. And pin right along down here, keeping that nice and flat. Yeah, that's where that, you know, starch, best press, do something to stabilize the bias. Makes your life so much easier. Okay, now down here, you see how that ends? Right there, you can see through there, that ends. Well, that's fine. I'll just put a little pin here, and you don't actually have to sew down there. Okay, so I'm gonna take this to the machine, and there we go, glasses on. Alrighty. And I'm gonna put this right in here like this. Oopsies. Okay, and I'm just going to put that presser foot down. You can see that the triangle is stopping there. That's where the fabric ends. I'm just gonna hold that and get the pin out of the way now. So when I drop that presser foot, I'm not dropping it onto a pin. Okay, you're just gonna let the fabric feed through. Get rid of that pin. Oops, there we go. And just kind of gently guide it through here. Okay, feeling underneath to make sure my seam allowance is going the direction I want it to. It's amazing what you can feel with your fingers when you're doing this. You can really help yourself not sew seam allowances the wrong way. You probably just noticed that a cat fur got sewn in here. You can imagine why. If you have a cat at home, cats are very helpful when you're quilting, aren't they? I have a cat that, it's really kind of tricky. He's both black and white, so it doesn't matter what fabric it's on, he's on, it's gonna show. All right, that's where it ends, right there. So I'm just gonna sew right on out there, like that, and then take it out. Ta-da. Okay. Now, when I press this open, oops, see under here, this big thing? That's gonna get trimmed off. So I'm just gonna do that first. I wanna make sure that I've got this aligned the way I want it before I trim that off. Because if I trim that off and then decide I need to, you know, re-sew it, I'm gonna be sad that I did it. Okay, see, that looks fine. That's fine. Now I'm just gonna come back under here. and trim that seam allowance off, the extra, that little triangle guy. Okay, and then the next thing is that big, that really big triangle. Okay, that 18-inch triangle is gonna go here. And you're gonna do the same thing I did before. You're just gonna fold that guy in half and just sort of, you know, give it a little finger press. And this is the center of that area. So right sides together like that and center that on that seam just like that. Okay. I'm gonna pin from this direction this time. There we go. And I'm gonna lay this out now where it's really flat because I wanna make sure that I have this going straight across this part. Okay, so if I align that with the edge just like that, make sure everything's just right. Okay, and I'm gonna pin it out here now before I mess with it too much over there. Pin that one there. And I'm gonna do the same thing down here. Kind of hold those ends. And then you can go ahead and pin if you want to. I recommend it because again, this is a big bias edge. And even though it's been stabilized with the best press, it's just as well to give it a little help. In case you don't know, the bias edge is the diagonal. So when you're actually holding your fabric, it would be the diagonal. So let's go over here and get this big one sewn on. This is another corner. And when you look at your diagram, you'll see where the big ones should be. It's pretty obvious which is the big corner, which is the small corner. Just remember, you're sewing the small corner first. Okay, so I'm just gonna start down here, get my presser foot down. Okay, and I'm just holding this very gently. I'm not pulling anything, I'm just letting the machine just bring it right in. And I can feel that seam allowance. I'm gonna make that sure that's flat. And just keep sewing. Get the pin out. I'm just really bad about getting pins out of the way. But I've had pins break and fly, and oh, it's important to get them out. And I can feel that I'm gonna have a point right there, one of my star points, but I'm pretty comfortable that my quarter inch seam allowance is right. So I think it'll work fine. Okay. Get that pin out of the way. Okay, this seam allowance that I pressed open, make sure that's nice and flat. You know, I think sometimes when we're sewing and quilting, we get sewing so fast because we're trying to get something done that we lose some of the pleasure. So when you're sewing this, enjoy what you're doing. Enjoy the fabric. You know, when you have fabric that you love, it makes all the difference in the world, doesn't it? We all know what it's like to sew with bad fabric. Ugh. Okay, get that seam allowance down. You know, when it's crunchy and really loosely woven and it doesn't cooperate. Oh. Just as a tip here, and I'm sure you've heard this before, but if you're gonna put hours and hours of your time into a project like a quilt, it makes sense to buy the best fabric you can afford because you've got hours and hours of your time into something like this. And if you use lousy fabric, it's just not gonna last. So buy the most high quality fabric you can afford. This is a matter of course. And there's really a difference. So, okay. So I'm gonna check this before I cut those off. Make sure I'm happy with it. Yeah, my points are good. Okay, looks nice, that's fine. I'm gonna do the same thing I did before. I'm just gonna trim that along the seam allowance like that. I'll do the same thing here. And then I'm gonna press this guy open. Okay. Like that. At home, you might do this a little more carefully than I'm doing it, but there we go. Okay, super. And now you can see that it's coming together and looking like the diagram. Okay, Now, we're going to pretend I did the other half, which is just like this, but reversed. And I want you to see how, like, the triangles aren't lining up. Well, that's fine. You know, this is kind of these edges are all over the place. Well, if you look at your diagram, that's what they look like. And what you're going to do next, you need to trim this big unit to 19 1/4 by 54 1/2. Okay, and the easiest way to do that, and I missed one, didn't I? Just get that out of the way real quick. Whoops. There we go. Just pulled an Eleanor Burns, didn't I? Whoa! Okay, if you don't know who Eleanor Burns is, she's a hero in the quilting world. She's the one who started us all on fabulous quilt in a day and things like that. And when she does a TV show, she just throws the fabric behind her. Okay, so when you have it laid out, you've got the whole thing there, what you're going to want to do is find the very center, okay, the center of the whole piece. And then what I would do, I would fold it there and measure. Now, you need to cut the length to 54 1/2. So I would fold in the middle, and you measure out half of that distance. So 54 1/2 divided by 2 is 27 1/4. I would just measure out to 27 1/4, and you just put a pin in there. And do the same thing here and the same thing here. Just a few little pins. It'll kind of give you a line. Okay? Then you would do the same thing this way. Now, don't go edge to edge from the triangles. You're just going, you know, arranging the blocks so you're going down the middle this way, okay? So that the point of this block is at the same place at the point on that block. Okay, like that. And I'm going to do the same thing. 19 1/4 divided by 2 is 9 5/8. I think so. And I would measure out 9 5/8 and put a little mark. You can even just a little pencil mark. Do that along so you have an idea of where you want to cut. Because what you want to do when you're trimming, you want to end up with this even so that you have the same amount of distance outside. You want this part centered, okay? And then what you can do is just take a yardstick or a ruler and connect your marks and then measure the whole thing. Measure all the way down, make sure you've got 19 1/4 inches here, 19 1/4 inches here, 19 1/4 inches here. Make sure you have the right width all the way down. You do the same thing with the length, 19 1/4 by 54 1/2. You trim this and a whole bunch of this stuff's gonna come off, and that's the way it's supposed to be. Okay, so there's your first section, section A, the rising stars section. And when we get together next time, we're going to be doing the log cabin blocks, which is section B. They're these beautiful green and teal and pretty blocks. And so go ahead, your homework is to go ahead and make your rising stars and make your section A and get it trimmed and all ready to go. And then you can go ahead and cut your log cabin pieces. Just make sure you get a good mixture of the teal and the green when you're cutting. You don't want all green or all teal. Just kind of get a good mixture. And I'll see you back here next time, and I'm going to show you how to chain piece.
This episode of McCall's Quilting Quilt Along is brought to you by Moda, producer of quilting fabric and home of the fabric pre-cuts.